Hey, how's it going, dreamers?
Happy Wednesday.
And welcome back to Dreaming with Drifters. Hope everybody's had a wonderful hump day, because guess what? It's hump day! it's been a...
If it will warm up, it will be a good day.
It's been a wishy-washy day. The sun doesn't know if it wants to come out and shine or if it wants to stay behind the gloomy clouds. I've already taken my jacket off 3 times this morning. Put it on, take it off. I know you have questions.
There's always questions.
I know.
Yeah, but there's always questions.
I know that you are wondering why I'm standing here with the hard hat on. Well, the big reason is because I'm trying to be safe.
Safety first. We do try.
Yeah. Although I know sometimes
we're not successful all the time, but we do try.
Yeah. I know I do get ahead of myself from time to time, and sometimes I do err on the side of caution every now and then. But sometimes I put caution to the wind and say, let's do it. This is going to be one of those times. Today... On the way to the bus stop this morning, actually, we were walking to the truck, and Jacob and Talon pointed something out to me that was pretty disturbing. And got to it and touched it a little bit, and when he touched it, the whole thing got nervous. I was like, all right, it's time to go. Let's go. We got to go catch the bus. Let me show you what I'm talking about, guys. This is going to make you say, ugh. Let's go see what I'm talking about. Little nail biting time. Matter of fact, we're right here already. See these rotten trees? Look at this. Look at that rotten tree. It is absolutely just dead. And what made me nervous was Jacob was all the way over here touching it. And this thing is just falling apart, guys.
So you touch it.
Well, I'm not an 11-year-old kid either.
I mean, I don't think that makes a difference.
I think it makes a lot of difference. I think the difference between me and an 11-year-old kid who don't know much about trees is know that if I touch it too hard, that tree's going to be crumbling down on top of me, and he didn't. So I think that. But I got the Husqvarna. Huh? You see? I got it right that time. Husqvarna. And I am going to be taking this tree down. And, well, both of them. I guess it's one tree or two. It splits up like that. But I'm going to do half at a time. And we are going to hope and pray, Lissa, that this tree doesn't fall on me. And here Odin, he's like, I want to come help, guys. I want to come help. Here, stand back here and just show everybody the top of this tree. And I'm just going to push on it just a little bit and watch the top of this tree wiggle. See it?
Yeah, a little bit.
Man. I could almost put my hand all the way through it. It's pretty scary. I'm gonna go ahead and grab my gloves and get my safety goggles on. And we're gonna see what we can do right here. Odin boy. You hear Odin?
Yeah.
We're not far enough away. He can still see us, so he feels like he should be right here. Odin and I had a good walk this morning. All right. Let's see. The pressure's on. Let's see if the chainsaw is going to be my friend this morning.
Should we stand over here or should we stand on the other side?
I would stand... I say at least right there. Maybe back up just a little bit. And I think just keep an eye out.
Thank you. Well, at least the boys caught this tree. We can get it down. Clearing some of the brush around it first. One down.
One more. I wasn't really worried about the first one. It was already leaning so heavily. The second one right here is the one I'm kind of nervous about. Hope it goes just as smooth.
Fingers crossed.
This is how you know, dreaming with drifters, we view and we upload. There's no editing because guess what, Lissa?
Huh?
We forgot to take the thumbnail before we cut the first tree down.
Ah.
I wanted to show everybody in the thumbnail how dead the tree was. So guess what? You guys get to take a thumbnail with us. We're going to go take a thumbnail with you. Come on. Before we cut this other tree down, let's take a thumbnail, guys. Let's take a thumbnail by this tree that's dangerous that we just cut down. Alright. Here we go. How's that? We gotta be able to see the tree. Gotta see the tree. We gotta point at it. Ah! There it is, guys. Behind the scenes. Thanks for being sub. Okay, here we go. I should have ate more breakfast.
You got this. Lost his hat.
Yeah! I like it when a plan comes together. Look how rotten this tree was. That's crazy. The kids were riding all weekend, last weekend, with the e-bikes going back and forth, and that's what made me so nervous, because Serenity and one of the other girls crashed the e-bike on the road and they fell into a tree, which was not a big deal. There's a lot of trees and brush piles along the side. But if they would have crashed into this, it could have been terrible. You know, one great thing about rotten pine trees, I smell it. Lighter knots. We'll have some good fires. All right.
Dang.
Oh, man.
Well, good job, my king.
Thank you. Here, let me assist you guys. Come over here. And would you like to show them what we've been doing in the front yard, or would you rather just post up right here? I guess it's okay. Come on, let's show them. This is what the driveway looks like. Uncle David did a really good job putting so many piles of rock.
You can't see them because the mud is covering it, but there's a lot.
Right. What do you think? Odin starts going crazy when we get up here?
Of course.
This is something else I'll be addressing today. I'm going to go ahead and get this one down too, my queen. Oh. I know we've kind of just gotten used to this tree, huh? We just walk right up underneath it. We've been walking under this tree now for months. And the root ball is just getting more and more. It would have already fell down if not for these other trees right here. So I think what I'm going to do, the easiest way for me to get this one down is to cut some littler ones down. We'll cut one, two, these little three right here, and we'll get them taken care of. Here's another cedar that I was getting ready and cutting up. Look how green and vibrant that is, my queen.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
So what we're going to show you next is something that we are planning in the future, but since it's already here, we're already taking steps to go ahead and get it done. I know in the live yesterday, we had our very first live for Dreaming with Drifters. Hey, I've been looking for these. Put them in a wheelbarrow where I can use them. In the live yesterday, sorry if it's really windy, I told you guys how I'm going to be taking all this stuff right here behind you. All the tin that we have and our scrap wood pile over here that we have and all our little timbers. I'm going to be taking all this stuff and putting it over here behind that pile right there, and that'll free up and make the front yard more pretty.
Yes.
And
we're gonna, all these trees are going.
Yep.
So,
and why will they be going?
A good bit of the section actually will be cleared out.
Right, check it out, all this stuff right here
and back,
all the way back behind those piles. Even gonna go ahead and get Uncle David's bed back up there.
Let's see how long he does to do it. It's already been, what, 6 months?
Hey! That's right.
What's another month?
What's another month? Trying to make it a year. Can we make it a year? You want to show him the second bloom?
Yes, it's not really blooming yet. But
well, show him the second bud. Let's go look at Lissa's second bud. Hi, Odin. The generator's running in the background in case you're wondering what that noise is.
We got another one coming.
Hey! Yay.
There hasn't been any that has bloomed over by the other tree yet, but give it some time.
And then this one is blooming nicely. Hey, Lo.
I do want to do something in the middle there.
Right.
I have a couple of ideas I'm playing with.
Yeah. Well, guys, this is going to be it for today. Got a long... I hear you. You're good. You're good. You guys just want to go inside. Spoiled doggies. Spoiled doggies. There is lots to do today, especially... Oh, there's Odin Boy. Especially since it's not raining. It was supposed to be raining today, and we were going to be cooped up inside. But now that it's not raining, we're going to be able to get a little bit more done. I'm going to get a little bit more progress on the dreaded dog fence. This project here.
It's not a dreaded dog fence. It's just
taking so long
to get it done.
So long, guys.
It's all right. It will get done, though. It's okay.
Yeah. I thought I was finished cutting posts. Cutting cedar down. However, I didn't think about the cross bracing, the H joints and the diagonal joints and stuff like that. And Uncle David asked me, he was like, I'm gonna be ready to do the fence and this and that. Did you get all your bracing done? And I was like, ooh, bracing. That's something I didn't think about. And if I know, hey, we know our friends over at Simple Life Reclaimed, Gary, he would have never forgotten about bracing.
No.
Okay, oh, man. It's okay. We'll get her done. What is that on the log right there? See that?
I mean, there's lots of logs.
No,
over there.
On the stump.
Your gloves, it looks like.
That's the gloves I was looking for. I was already out here this morning, guys, cutting down trees. I was looking for gloves. Man, check it out. Here's our newest update for the fence. None of these posts are nailed or screwed in or anything like that. But I was giving Lissa an idea of what it was going to kind of look like for the bracing. See what I mean, though, my queen? That's what I'm calling an H brace. And on every corner post, there needs to be a brace going to the opposite post this way. And then I got this big one down here to go to the opposite post this way. And you should also have an H brace by the gate. And since this is a gate log right here, we got a brace going this way. This is the other gate right here. And it'll be coming to the middle because this is our middle run going down. And I've started just laying stuff out. I've already got this corner done. Wow! Look at that, my queen. Look at all the grass growing.
Grass, flowers.
Look at this.
And even weeds, I'm happy to see.
Look at the grass. Oh.
That makes me excited.
Look at the flowers. Who would have thought? You know what, my queen? I am so glad that we didn't just use Uber and rip all this ground up.
Me too.
Because there would have been no grass, no flowers. Oh, look over here by the stump. Look at all the flowers over by the stump, my queen.
They're starting to bloom for us too.
Yep. Absolutely beautiful. Well, dreamers, I guess we're going to go ahead and let you go now for sure. You know I'm a long goodbyer. Wait until all you awesome people come to the meetup and have a chance to meet us. You'll know for real in person it's a long goodbyer. I also want to give a small shout out real quick to the unknown named person. I was in Dollar General and I was in the checkout line and another woman was checking out. And she goes, hey, my husband watches your channel every night. And I was like, wow, that's great. Cool. Tell him I said thanks. And then she just kind of walked away looking at me. And so I got done and I checked out and I went and followed her. I said, hey, what's your name? Or what's your husband's screen name or whatever? We'll give him a shout out on the channel and say hi. And she was like, oh, he uses my name. I was like, oh, well, what's your name? And I forgot. She told me, but I forgot. But you know who you are and you know who the husband is. And if you guys see us in Dollar General all the time, hey!
We love you, dreamers. We'll catch you on the next one. Have a great Wednesday. We love you guys. Bye.
Bye, guys.
Stick your tongue out. Yeah.